Hey guys, my name is Pedrotsky, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up a Sven Co-op dedicated server. Now, if you've never set one up before and you're on this video, you've probably seen this post already. It's a huge text wall and overly complicated, so don't worry. I'm going to show you a way easier way of setting up a server using Pterodactyl. Now, Pterodactyl is like a game management software, and it just makes managing your servers, editing them and just making sure they're up and running, makes it like 1000% easier than just using a command line. So if you haven't got Pterodactyl set up on your server, just simply go to the link in the description. I've got a how-to guide on how to set that up, and it literally takes only 5 to 10 minutes, and it's super simple. But trust me, in the end it's going to be way better using this software than using your command line or whatever else you're going to use to run Sven Co-op. So once you've installed Pterodactyl on your server, you'll be at a screen like this. And this basically says there's no servers associated with your account, so we have to add Sven Co-op. Now, all we need to do is go to settings, and then we need to go to nests. Then we're going to create a new nest. I'm going to call it custom games. And then we have to get what's called an egg. So an egg, it's a configuration file that allows you to install third-party servers. Now, if you go in the description, there's a link here to Parker's repo for different eggs. And basically, this has just got like a ton of different games that you could run, like a ton of different, Steam CMD servers that you can just run just through Pterodactyl super simply. So what we're going to do, we're just going to download this entire repo. So we click on code, click download zip, and basically what that's going to do, that's going to download to our computer. So we'll just give that a second to go through, and then we just need to extract the files. So just extract. And then inside of here, you'll see we've got every single file from this repository. So now we can go back to Pterodactyl, and then we can click on import egg. And then we're going to choose the file for Sven Co-op. So we go in here, and then that's under game eggs, Steam CMD servers, Sven Co-op. And yeah, so we just double click on it, and then we're going to add it to the nest custom games. Like, to be honest, it can go in any of these really, but just for organization's sake, it's better to put it under custom games. So let's click import. And now once we've imported it, then we actually can set the server up. So let's go over to servers now. Click on create new. Then we're going to type in the server owner name, so in my case it's Pedrowski. Then we can scroll down. You can basically leave everything else here as default. Memory, we're going to set this to 0, disk space to 0. This basically is just going to, as it says here, set to 0 to allow unlimited disk usage. We can leave everything else here as a default. You don't need to change it. The only thing we need to change here is the nest configuration. So we need to change this from Minecraft to custom games. So think of nests as just like a folder basically, and then it says here the egg is Sven Co-op. And then there's a few different variables here, so you can change the default map or the server name if you want, max players, etc. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on server, create server. It looks like I forgot the name, so let's go Sven Co-op. Then click on create server. So it says here, server was created successfully, so let's go to Pterodactyl. And then we can actually watch the server installing right here before our eyes. So all you need to do is just wait probably 10 or 15 minutes, and once it's done, we'll come back to it. Okay, so now we can see that the installation is finished, and it says running up here. It's been running for 47 seconds. So we can actually just click on the IP address here, and that's going to copy it to the clipboard, and then we can connect directly to our server. So we can go to Steam. Let's load up Sven Co-op. And then once we're in, we can literally just press tilde on the keyboard. So tilde is the button that's next to one. It's like a little squiggly line. We press that and then click type connect. And then we can paste in our IP address here. And then that should connect us straight up to the game server. Take a minute just while it's downloading that file, but yeah, here we go. We're inside Sven Co-op and we're connected up to the server. Obviously I've got bad ping, but that's just because my internet connection sucks. But yeah, that's it guys. That's how you set up Sven Co-op dedicated server inside of Pterodactyl. If you get stuck at any time, then make sure you check the link in the description. I've got my Discord server there, so you can come join and basically we can help you out, get it set up. Just ask your question in the tech support channel. And yeah, if this video was helpful, just give it a like and a comment below and let me know. So thanks for watching guys, and I hope to see you in the next videos.